Here's a good exercise when you want to learn Illustrator a little bit better. It's a good thing to try and deconstruct some images or logos or something like that that other people have done. You don't know how this has been made, this particular logo here. And by the way, it's not mine. I don't know who did this, so if it happens to be yours, it's just for demonstration purposes. Okay. So this is a bitmap at the moment, and you can see clearly, if I can just zoom in a bit there, you can see it's very jagged. It's a bitmap image. Okay, so what we want to do is make it into a nice, smooth Illustrator vector graphic. And you know, sometimes people will send you logos like this, and they say, you know, can you convert this into something nice for me? So the job is to know exactly, you know, how this has been constructed. Just kind of tracing it is not a very good idea. Not with this one, because it's, you know, there's a lot of nice smooth curves there. It just wouldn't work if you traced it. I think we need to know how it's made. Okay, so my first instinct when I first saw this, I thought, I think this is a 3D image using the 3D features of Illustrator. So I'm going to do that, and let's see how we get on with this. Okay. Right, so first of all, we need a background for this image. And I'll use this one actually. I'll just use this. Now in 3D, we're going to use the revolve function. So we need to, I've lost my tools, there we are. So we need to just have this this circle here. There's about five different ways to do that. I'll just do it like this for now. Okay, and we'll take the fill away because we don't want any fill in there, and I'll make the stroke just a plain blue stroke because we're going to take it into the 3D. Now what I've done is I've made here this pattern. I made this earlier, you know, just these sort of rectangles like that at an angle. You can see that I've used the grid as well to make sure that, you know, there's sort of two spaces of grid between them. If you want to follow along with this, that's the way to do that. Okay. Oh, and by the way, if you're wondering how I got them at that angle like that, they were just normal rectangles, and I got the direct selection tool and just selected the end handles, so you can see they're now solid and those are still white, which means if you move one, you can move them at a certain angle. Okay, I'll just undo that because I've already got them at the right angle. Okay, right, so this then needs to be dragged into the symbols palette, and you just simply get a hold of it and drag it. I've already got it in there actually. There it is. It's called new symbol one. But the way you do it is you just get hold of the whole thing if you can. Yeah, make sure you select all of it and just drag it into the new symbol, into the symbol palette. You can leave it on movie clip, it doesn't make any difference, and we'll click OK. Right, I've actually got two in there now, but it doesn't matter. Right, so now we'll try the 3D bit and see what we get. This should be interesting. I'm going to select that, go to Effect and 3D and Revolve. Okay. I've just realized that the actual line I've got there is a gradient, which is, I don't actually want a gradient there. So, because you can put gradients now in the stroke, but a gradient stroke isn't very good for this particular exercise. Okay, so select it, go to Effect, 3D, and Revolve. Okay, click Preview. So there's my already, you know, the sort of background that I'm going to use, right? And then we go to Map Art here. And we use the first face, they're different faces, but the first one that comes up, one of two there, that's the one we need. And in the symbol, choose the, so in my case, it's new symbol 3, okay? We put that in there, and already you can see here, already you can see, you know, it's starting to fill the object. Okay, we want it to fit the entire area. And by the way, if you're wondering what this graph represents, the dark parts of that represents the hidden areas of the object, and the white part are the things you can see, or the parts you can see. But if you click this scale to fit here, my little graphic will fit the whole thing. And there you can see now, it's completely sort of covering the object. You can stretch them out a bit if you want them to be a bit wider, if you want to. You see there, they're going a bit wider. But I think in this case it's just about right, really. So we'll just leave it like that for now, and click OK. And now what we need to do, of course, is position this so it's looking from above rather than, you know, just front on, as that is almost front on. So if we just move this around a bit, and there you can see the preview there. And if I just play around with this so that this area here is sort of in that position there. So we just play with this a little bit here and just tip it up a little bit. And just maybe a little bit more. And that, I think, is about right. That's about the right position. Okay, it's kind of, you know, it looks similar. All right, let's carry on anyway. Yeah, that's all right. The shading looks right as well, but maybe the white lines are a bit thick. In order to change that, we'd have to go right back to the beginning and alter the actual graphic that we dragged in the symbols. But I'm just going to leave it for now and click OK. So we're kind of getting what we want, kind of. And I did think that this area here was a separate sort of circle. So I made a circle here, and I sort of put that on there. And yeah, you see, it's kind of right. But what I did notice, the interesting thing here, is this is true perspective, yeah, because it's 3D. It's true perspective, meaning that some of these sort of lines are sort of thinner, you know, there's a definite perspective. Whereas on this one, as I say, I originally thought it was 3D, but now when I look at it, I'm thinking, well, these white strokes to the circles, if you look carefully, they're all exactly the same width, which is odd. And now that I've done this, I'm thinking, okay, you know, maybe that isn't the way. It was a good idea, but it's not quite right. So I'm going to put this to one side. I'll put it down here. And what I'm going to do now is if you look carefully at these, they are perfect circles. And as I say, they are the same width. So what I did is I just got a few circles, and I've got them down here at the bottom just to save time when I show you. I'm going to bring them on here. And I just made these circles and I positioned them as best as I could. Oop, not like that. Hang on, let's get them all together. There we are. Them all together. And I positioned them on as best as I could, like that, so that each circle, I used the black lines just so I could see what I was doing. And just about each circle there is, that one just needs moving just slightly over. I'm just using the arrow keys to move it over there. There we are. So that the black line is absolutely in the middle of the white stroke there, just so they're in the right position. I'm not worried about this centre bit because I think that's a separate bit. So, okay, so I've got that. Fine. Right, I'm going to move that out of the way. I'm going to use these and put them on top of this graphic here. Oh, and by the way, just before I do that, I think this highlight here needs to be in a different place. I've just realized that. So the highlight needs to be sort of here, the same here. You can see it's sort of lighter here and then goes darker, so I'll fix that using this gradient tool thing. And we can just kind of do this, just pull that out like that and then possibly move it a bit. There we go, that's better. So the highlight is now there, which is pretty much the same as that one. Okay, let's take these lines and put them on the top of that. Right, they're at the back at the moment, so I'll just bring them to the front. So they're now at the front. And I think I'm just going to lock the sort of back circle just for the moment. I'm going to just lock that in place. There we are. Just makes it a bit easier when we move these. Okay, so I'm going to attempt to, let me move this closer and then we can see it. Okay, I'm going to attempt to sort of get these the same width as that. So first of all, they need to be white, of course. So we'll make them white because we can see them clearly now. And if I just click in there, by the way, this is CS6 and it's got this nice new feature that you don't have to choose the size from there. You can just click in the actual box there and use your arrow keys to go up. So I'm using the, you know, up, down, left and right arrows on the keyboard. So I'm just going to attempt to get the sort of right width there. And is that about right, would you say? Yeah, I think so. Actually, I think it's just a bit thicker than what I need. And yet, if I do 6, that's too thick. So I think I need 5.5, and it is possible to do that. 0.5. And that will give us a nice set there. That's just about right. I think they're the right size. And now if I just kind of move them over a little bit, because you can see we've got some of the blue sticking out there and yet there it kind of disappears. So again, using the arrow keys, I'm just going to kind of move them over. Until we get something similar to that. Now I've also just realized that my background thing is not quite right. I think it got sort of flattened and moved accidentally before. There we are. Okay, so that's kind of right, isn't it? Look, that's just about, I would say that's pretty close. That's pretty close. I'll just lock this background thing again just while we're at it. lock the selection there. Right. Okay, that's not bad. And now to really make it the same as this, I've got a circle, which I did earlier again. I've just made sure it's exactly the same size as that. And it wants to be no stroke, just a white circle. And I'm going to put it on there and arrange it so that it's the same as the other one. And if we again use the arrow keys, it'll allow us to just fix that right. There we go. And that, I do believe, is the way it was done. This was a good idea to start with, but that is pretty much the way this object was created, and that's a nice clean object that can be resized, and because it's vector, you can have it the size of a bus if you want, or you can have it on a postage stamp. But the thing is, it, you know, it's a nice vector image. And you know, this is a typical example that you can look at something and think, oh yeah, that's actually quite complicated. And yet it's turned out that it wasn't that complicated at all. It wasn't a 3D object, it was just simply, you know, simple circles put on top of each other. And you know, sometimes it can work out like that. Other times you can have an object that looks very simple, and yet when you come to try to recreate it, it's a bit more complicated than you thought. But in this case, it's worked out the other way around, so that's good. And I think that was a pretty good exercise of figuring out how that was done. And I'll tell you, it took me a while to figure this out. And while I was doing it, you know, there was all kinds of little things that I was coming up with, little mistakes or just accidental things, serendipity as we call it. And here, if I just show you here, there's a few sort of examples of some of the things that you can come up with just by playing around. And it might not be exactly what you want, but at least you can say, well, you know, they're all right, I'll keep them for later. They could come in really useful for later, especially this type of thing here. I was experimenting there to see if I, you know, get these sort of lines in the right place. It didn't work, but it's still, you know, a nice object which I can save for later. Okay, so don't be afraid to have a look at other people's work and deconstruct it. Now, the more you do of that, the more you learn. And also you can, you know, get yourself a nice little portfolio of shapes that you can use perhaps later on for logos or things like that. And people will be wondering, how the heck did she do that? Well, you know, there it is. So hopefully that should work for you. Okay, bye-bye. Happy illustrating.